Good morning, I am Daniela Pareja and I am going to present a new spool-and-line attachment method to track short movements in Phyllomedusid frogs. I will start by defining movement. According to Nathan and collaborators, movement is defined as the change in the spatial location of an individual in time. For breeding amphibians, we have two types of movements. Migration, which is defined as movement mainly of adults from and toward breeding ponds. And dispersal, which is an unidirectional movement from birth ponds to breeding sites. There are different methods to monitor frog movements, like transmitters, fluorescent powders, and the spool and line. The spool and line is a cocoon-shaped spool of thread that is attached to the study animal, and as the animal moves, the thread unwinds and it is possible to trace its course. There are several studies with this methodology with frogs. These two studies, as you can observe here, attach the spool and line to the waist of the individuals. It worked out really good for Leptodactylus, however, it didn't work out very good for Phyllomedusa trinitatis, since Gurevich and Downey's study found several problems due to entanglement of the thread. There are several advantages of using the spool and line, like the low cost. You can buy 1 kilogram of thread bobbins for $10 versus one transmitter for $100 or more. You can adapt the size to the size and weight of the individual. And finally, it gives you more details of the movements and distances. So our objectives were to conceptualize a new harmless technique to attach thread bobbins to adult tree frogs using Phyllomedusa burmeisteri as a model, and to test this new technique in the field. So this is Phyllomedusa burmeisteri. It is a frog endemic to Brazil, which is associated with lentic bodies of water. This is one of our study sites, the Cabruca at our university, located in northeastern Brazil. And then we also did some work at the Reserva Ecológica Michelin, which is located in southern Bahia in northeastern Brazil too. This is a reserve that has a mosaic of primary, secondary forest and different areas of regeneration. So we started testing different materials that were used before in other studies. We first tested bands or elastic materials for handcraft. We attached them to the waist of our individuals, but it moved a lot, as you can see here. And also they hurt the individual's waist. We then used some silicone gloves, which turn out very well for other species. However, not so good for our Phyllomedusas because it hurt them a lot, even hours after we attached these devices. We then tested with silicone. We did a diaper, a harness type, but the problem with silicone was that the silicone started absorbing water and also hurt the individual's waist. We tested with another type of sealant. This sealant was lighter, however, it wasn't strong enough and the individual lost the device after an hour. So it worked out really good in the lab, as you can see here. However, when we take the individuals to the field, they all lose their devices in less than an hour. So we face two challenges here: the material, because it had to be lighter and harmless, and the type of methodology, a backpack or a harness, what is best for the Phyllomedusas. So we also face the problem of the body shape, weight, and behavior and movements of Phyllomedusas. As you can see here, the waist of Phyllomedusa burmeisteri is much smaller than that of Rhinella or Leptodactylus, and as a result, frogs easily lose their band devices attached to their waist when they started climbing trees, for example. So, we found the light at the end of the tunnel for the material with this disposable butterfly needle. However, we still had trouble finding out what's best, a harness or a backpack. Even if previous studies have tested waistband attachment methodology to be very positive, this waistbands concentrated a lot of weight here in the waist of the Phyllomedusa and hindered their movements. So we thought that the backpack was a better solution for this type of frogs. Now that we had the suitable material, we created the tracking device, making these two circles out of these microtubes of the needle, and two other pieces for the dorsal and the ventral part. It is very important to consider that the dorsal part has to be very straight in order that no edge of the device directly has contact with the skin. So this is the bobbin made out of nylon, which is wrapped with a plastic wrap and then with silver tape to protect them from water and humidity. The devices weighed no more than 10% of the individual's weight. As you can see here, the Phyllomedusa is with the backpack. So our field work, the first step is to capture our individuals, and since Phyllomedusa have these color patterns in their ventral parts of the head, it was very easy to photo ID them. The second thing is to weight and measure the individuals. Remember that the devices have to be less than 10% of the individual's weight. And then since the device was very easily assembled, we had the pieces ready and constructed it in the field so that then we can release them at the exact place we found them. And we observed them for a couple of minutes to see if the device was well attached, if the individual moved correctly, etc. The next day, we marked the points where the individuals have moved to, and then we measured distances between the points and take also the angle, the turning angle, and the GPS coordinates. So we believe that this methodology is very effective since the Phyllomedusas were able to move, as you can observe on the video, throughout branches, leaves, and there was no entanglement of the thread or knots. They also used burrows and difficult places and were able to get out without any trouble. So we tracked a total of 15 individuals, 3 females and 12 males. So here we have a projection of the GPS coordinates and the distances, which give us the distances they moved. The average distance in the Cabruca was 5.17 and in the Michelin 15.24. So some of our conclusions are that this is the least invasive method that we have found. Even if two of our subjects have developed minor wounds after the 4th day, we resolve this, making this a very rectangular shape of the device for the dorsal part. And we also were very careful not to fit the backpack too tightly so that they could move freely. It also allows us to follow horizontal and vertical movements. And this is very important since Phyllomedusas climb trees, but can also be found on the floor. This is a very effective methodology for short movements no longer than 5 days. We can adapt the thread bobbins to the size and weight of the individuals, which make it this methodology replicable and less expensive compared to other ones. We encourage you to test with this methodology with other groups. We have started testing it with other tree frogs and it worked out really, really well. So we are part of the Herpeto Movement Ecology Group, and I thank you very much for your attention.